Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 2.2, Problem 6. This is Section 2.2, Problem Number 6. It says the following is a list of the ages of all U.S. presidents at the time of their inauguration. Construct a frequency distribution with a first class of 40 to 44. So let me see if I fit that right next to this. And as I look through, how far up am I going to have to go? It looks like there were two people elected who were 69 when they were inaugurated. So again, when they say frequency distribution, I'm going to have a chart with two columns. So the first one, we can call it class, or you can label it age at inauguration if you want, however you like to label it. And the second column will be frequency, which I'll abbreviate. And the direction said, start with the first class of 40 to 44. So that will be my first class. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to keep listing classes until I get up far enough to accommodate my oldest president. So the next class, if the first class ends at 44, the next one would have to start at 45. And again, you might think it's 45 to 50, 50 to 55. You can't begin a class and end the next one at the same one. So to go from the lower limit to the upper limit of the class that they gave us to start with, I'm adding 4. 40 plus 4 is 44. So for the next one, I'm doing 45 plus 4 is 49. Then if the second class ends at 49, the third one must begin at 50. And then 50 plus 4 more would give me my ending point or upper class limit. 50 plus 4 is 54. And now if my third class ends at 54, the next class, the fourth one, would begin at 55. And now again, because I'm adding 4 to get to the upper class limit, 55 plus 4 is 59. And then if my fourth class ends at 59, the next class, the fifth one, would begin at 60. Again, I can have no gaps and no overlaps. Where one ends, the next one has to start just one more than that. So, and I'm adding 4 to go from the beginning point to the ending point for each class, for the lower limit to the upper limit. 60 plus 4 is 64. Still not quite big enough for my oldest president. The next class will hit it, though. 64, the next class would have to start at 65. And then for the ending point of that final class, 65 plus 4 is 69. So that will accommodate the oldest president in the list. If there was somebody a little bit older, I'd have to even put one more class beyond that. I'll just neaten this up a little bit, make it a nice looking chart. Now what I have to do is carefully go through the list and count up how many presidents were between age 40 and 44 when they were inaugurated. You can go side to side or up and down in columns. The rows are pretty long, so I'll go up and down. This first column, there's nobody between 40 and 44. The next one, there's nobody between 40 and 44. The next one, nobody between 40 and 44. 48 is close, but a little too big. Same thing with the next column. Again with the next one. The next column, though, does have a 42. 42 is between 40 and 44, so there's one. And the next column has a 43, that's between 40 and 44. And there are no other data values between 40 and 44. So two presidents were between 40 and 44 at the time of their inauguration. So the frequency for that first class is 2. And just for your own trivia, the 42 was Teddy Roosevelt, and the 43 was John F. Kennedy. Kennedy was the youngest person ever to be elected to office. Teddy Roosevelt took office when the president before him was assassinated, and Teddy was the vice president. So he was the youngest to ever hold the office of president, but JFK was the youngest to be elected to the office of president. And then I don't know any of the rest of them, I just know those two. So anyway, the next class, 45 to 49. So the first column, again, nobody's between 45 and 49. The next column, same result. Here's 2 in this third column. So I have 2. is 3, 4, 5, 6, so I got 6, let me see, oh no, I missed one. 46, that's why it's not a bad idea to cross them off as you use them. So 7. There are 7 presidents that were between 45 and 49 when they were inaugurated. So the next class, how many presidents were between 50 and 54 years old when they were inaugurated? So between 50 and 54. So basically, anyone left not crossed out that's 54 or younger. Nobody in the first column. Here's 2 in the second, so 2, 3, 4, this one's a little too big, I'll get this president next time, 5, 6, too big, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So if I didn't miss any, 13. So anyone left that are not crossed out, 54 and younger. Just a quick check. There's a few that are close, but a little too big. So I think it's 13. So now the next class, presidents that were between 55 and 59 years old when they were inaugurated. So basically anything left that's not crossed off, 59 or younger. So now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I don't see any others. So 12. There were 12 presidents. They're between 55 and 59 years old when they were inaugurated, so frequency is 12. And again, before I go to the next class, let's just see if there's anybody left 59 or younger. It doesn't look like it. Okay. So, 2 classes left. The next one between 60 and 64 years old at the time of their inauguration. So, basically 64 or younger that hasn't been crossed off yet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So there were 7 presidents that were between 60 and 64 years old when they were inaugurated. And again, just a quick check, anybody 64 or younger left without a red X? A little too big. Looks good. So, the last class, presidents that were between 65 and 69 years old when they were inaugurated. Here's 1, 2, 3, 4. And there are none left without an X, so 4. Now, just to check it, this should be right, but there are 45 numbers in this list. You can either count them off, happen to know that we've had 45 presidents, or you can see that there's 5 rows of 9 values. 5 times 9, 45. Now, however you come up with that 45, a nice thing to do would be to see that your frequencies add up to 45. It's not a guarantee. You may have made 2 mistakes where one cancels the other out. But if it adds up to 44 or 46, I made a mistake. So let's see what we get. 2 plus 7 is 9. 9 plus 13 is 22. 22 and 12 is 34. 34 plus 7 is 41. And then it works. 41 plus 4 more is 45. Good. So that's the frequency distribution for the ages of the presidents when they were inaugurated.